Rent control is up for debate again in one local city. Tonight, Marina Mobile Home Park residents, landowners, and city leaders got into a heated debate over the issue, trying to decide whether to create a rent control ordinance. It is such a hot topic, even people outside the town came to listen in. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong is live in Marina tonight with the latest for us.
Good evening, Aaron. We're in front of one of the mobile home parks here in Marina, one of five parks here in town. Now, some people who live here say that they are just getting more and more anxious as their rent continues to go up, so they want this ordinance. But others, some from out of town, came to argue that this ordinance would be just a waste of both time and money.
I've had tons of bad experiences because it's all about money. I got control, I make you pay.
For a decade, this has been a big debate surrounding Marina's mobile home parks. For the past couple of years, the focus shifted to a possible rent control ordinance. Monday night, the discussion started up again in the form of an ad hoc committee meeting. Residents on one side, landowners on the other. Dan Amadeo is neither, but he's just as upset.
The city council very recently voted to spend up to $20,000 just to get the terms of the ordinance framed by a lawyer.
Amadeo, whose wife sits on the city council, is pushing for a memorandum of understanding or a long-term lease because of their flexibility. But some people are still nervous.
It's only temporary, you see? And they're in control. While they're in control, forget it.
They don't understand what a lease is.
As tempers flared, one woman in the crowd hoped to change some minds. Gail Levy lives in a Capitola mobile home park owned by the same man who owns three parks in Marina, Al Vieira. She and her neighbors were able to strike a deal with Vieira back in January when Capitola adopted its rent control ordinance, which she says would have eventually quadrupled her rent.
Negotiated directly with Mr. Vieira outside of the city of Capitola's rules and regulations. And we actually crafted a very favorable, long-term, 12-year, fully transferable lease that is just fabulous.
As we mentioned, there were some people who came to the meeting from out of town. They expressed interest because they say rent control is a very fluid issue in the state and that what happens here could impact other cities. And in fact, Marina would be the first city on the Monterey Peninsula to have this kind of rent control ordinance if it does pass. Aaron.
All right, Stephanie, thank you. City leaders at tonight's meeting said that they were inclined to approve a rent control ordinance to protect residents. City Council will see the first draft of an ordinance, of such an ordinance, in 2 to 4 weeks.